Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein, and this week I want to show you some of the workflows that I live by every single day. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because earlier this week, or as you're watching this video, I suppose last week, I did a Todoist office hours video where I took participants in the webinar through some workflows that they can build for themselves using Todoist's amazing, powerful filters in order to create a lot simpler way of doing their work every single day. Now, I've covered my workflows a few times in this series, but what I want to do is just show you some of these extra ones that I brought in to this particular webinar. Now, the full webinar, by the way, is available on YouTube, and you can get that by the link below. But this one's going to give you a 10-minute summary of basically something that took 50 minutes to do in the actual webinar. So before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on using Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let's get straight into it, and I'll show you some of these brilliant workflows. Okay, so let's get started with the first one that I actually covered in this video, which is for those of you who are working in an environment where you need to follow up with clients and customers. Maybe you have to follow up with your colleagues. Whatever you have to do, most of us have some form of communication that we need to follow every single day. Now, the problem for most people is we end up with a long label if we're doing it by label. So I've got a label here, for example. This is just a demo account, but quite often you'll find there could be 30, 40 different follow-ups on one particular list. And when you look at a list of 30, 40 items, it just becomes really overwhelming. So what you want to be able to do is to break this down so that you only see the calls and the follow-ups that you want to do that day. Likewise with email, you could have a load of emails that you need to follow up with, and as I've got some samples here, these could, I mean, there's certain different dates, but I don't want to be looking at the whole list because it becomes distracting. So what you can do is you can create a filter, and what I've done is I've created a filter called Today's Communications, and essentially what that filter is essentially using the labels calls and emails and also today. So this only gives me the calls and the emails I want to reply to today. So in this particular example, for the filter query, it is today and then open brackets at calls and then the vertical line, which I can never remember what that line is called, and at email, close brackets. Now, the reason why we're putting brackets around that, it means that you see that as one thing. So calls and then the vertical line means or. So if you used an and, it would mean that it would only show you communications that have both calls and email as a label. When you use the vertical line, it means or. So you bring them together by closing the bracket and then click on add to favorites, because you're creating a workflow. So what you want is a workflow. So when I click on my today's communications, these are all for today, Friday the 13th of November. So I only have four things I need to do in terms of communications. Now, this could change throughout the day because I could be adding stuff to my inbox, but it's still, it's in my inbox. And as long as you're checking your inbox every day, you're going to see those and you'll be able to get back to them. But these are for your planned calls and your planned follow-ups. So you can actually just create that particular filter. Now, in my normal Todoist, I call this next one called the Golden 10, but this essentially is tomorrow's plan. And so what it has is, tomorrow is a Saturday and I only have my business development at the moment. So what it is I want to see any task, because I look at this at the end of the day. So I see any task that I haven't completed today will be showing on this list. As you can see here, it's still in the morning, so I haven't completed these tasks yet. But then I've also got tomorrow. So the filter for that, I have shown this one a few times actually, but tomorrow's plan, this is a way of just keeping it simple, is just having a creating a filter that is 2 days. So that will include today and tomorrow and then not P4, because P4 are usually routine tasks or tasks that are not so important. So I want to see the tasks that I've decided are important in one list when I'm doing my plan, and I can then decide if these are still relevant and if I still want to do them. So that's the filter for that. So it's 2 days, which means today and tomorrow, and not, that's the exclamation mark, P4. A fantastic little filter just to get you focused on the next day. And the reason why you can call it tomorrow's plan, and that's, I call it the golden 10, but that means something else to me, but you might want to call this tomorrow's plan because it makes you think about terms of what is your plan for tomorrow. And then you have a closing down filter. Now, the thing about this is there are certain things that you may have to do every single day. So in this case, I have to clean up my admin for today. I have to clear my action this day folder in my email, and I need to add my expenses to my expenses sheet. I like to do that every day. So that will come up as part of my routines every single day. So I have three things that will automatically come up on my closing down. But if I go down to this label here, so I've got closing label, there are five items on this. Now there could be more in your case. Like, for example, I could be going near the supermarket tomorrow, or I may go near the supermarket every Saturday morning. So in this case, this is set for tomorrow, Saturday, and it comes up at my closing. Actually, that one should be today because I want to check it today. But you can create like update sales report. Let's say I do that every Saturday morning. So I don't need to see that today. I can see that tomorrow. So what I've got is I've got my closing down for today. Now, the filter for closing down is, again, it's really quite simple. You probably get it now. I like simplicity. So again, it's just today and at closing. So all it's going to show is anything that's got a label closing with today's date. That's it. That's all it's going to show me. And as you can see, I've added it to favorites. Now, a quick tip with these favorites. Favorites goes in a specific order. So your projects will always be at the top of the list. Your labels will then come next, and then your filters. So I only use filters for my workflow simply because I can then order my workflow here. So my day starts with today's objectives. And I've covered this many, 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 many times. Today's objectives, the filter for that is really quite simple. It's just today and P1. The items that have given the red flag, that is it. That's the only ones that I give it. And that's only ever going to be a maximum of two. So today it's just exercise and record the podcast. Then I have my focus tasks. Now my focus tasks do include the objectives simply because these are the tasks that I've prioritized for today. I'm going to focus on these, and this is the list that I will have all day. And that list is likely not to be more than 10 items. And I keep that essentially is the window that I have open throughout the day. And what I actually do for most of the part, particularly when I'm using my big screen, is I actually narrow this down to this level so that I can have this up in a corner when I'm doing on my main screen. So when I'm doing my work, I can see this list getting smaller and smaller throughout the day. A very, very good way of doing it. So that's how I do my workflow. So essentially my workflow starts with, I like to look in the morning at what I've decided are my objectives for the day. Then I would go into where I stay most of the day, which is my today's focus. These are the 10 tasks that I've decided must be done today, or at least I will do my very best to get those completed. Then I've got my today's communications. Now I'm one of those people who has specific time each day that I will do my communications. Usually I'm going to do this, particularly for phone calls, I'll probably do that around 3, 4 p.m. or in the evening time, I will do my email. So this is where I can just quickly go into there and just see the 4 or 5 items that I need to communicate today. And it just keeps things nice and simple. Then once I've done that, I'm into closing down the day. So I look at tomorrow's plan, make sure I've not overscheduled myself, and I compare that with my calendar. And then I've got the closing down, which are just those routine tasks that need to be done today. And that can be 5 or 6 things. It really doesn't matter, but most of them just take 2 or 3 minutes to do. And that's the idea about building workflows. But it does go a little bit further. What you can do is you can also, particularly if you're using Gmail, what you can do, and I shared this in the actual seminar the workshop, the webinar, if you like. And what I've got here is I've got clear action this day folder. Now, the problem with email is our inboxes can become a place of distraction. So easily get caught up in what we've got in our inboxes. When I'm clearing my action this day folder, these are the emails that I need to respond to. So if I tap on that, that's going to open up my Gmail, and that is going to give me my action this day emails for today. And it's a really, really simple way of staying focused. Now, this one at the moment is not my, this is my demo account. So it's not actually brought me up where I want to do. And I've got 374 in my demo email account. Wow. But what I've done is that's actually logged into a different account. But on my real Todoist, this is logged into my main Gmail account, my carlpullein.com account. And that will take me to the email that I've got actionable today. Now, the way to do that, and I will just click on that again. I'll show you how to do that. What you do is you go to your Action This Day folder, and I've got one right here. This is my demo account, so I don't show you my private real email. In fact, actually, it has now opened up the Action This Day folder, as you can see. So this Action This Day is a label that I have in Gmail. If you do on the Mac, you do command highlight the actual web URL and copy that URL. And then, so I'm going to do that. I'll show you, copy that. And I'm going to go into my Todoist, create a new task. So we create a new task and clear. And there's a specific reason why I use this phrase folder, I'll call it. And the reason I do that is simply because it's very action orientated. Now, what you want to do is you want to put this in brackets. So open brackets, close brackets at the end, like that. And then at the front, if you just tap, make sure you put your cursor at the front. I'll put my cursor at the front. Oh, I'll do it the hard way then. Put my cursor at the front, put a space in, go back one, and then paste in the task. What you'll see is I now get the email icon here. And I've got a link directly to that Action This Day folder. Great way for your workflow, because then you're not going to get distracted by whatever's in your email inbox. Likewise, I have another one in here, which I think I've got it in here. Review my master projects list. So if I tap on that, that's going to take me into my Evernote's master project list. Now, this is a demo. This is actually my real list, looking at that. These are the lists that I've got for my projects that I'm working on right now. So this one here is something I'm working on right now as I'm speaking. And this one here is something I'm in the process of planning. So these here is my master projects list. So I can see very quickly what projects I've got coming up, where I'm at, and what I'm doing. Now, this is the old Evernote. Oh, I love this one. This is in my demo computer. I haven't upgraded to the new Evernote on this particular one. But this is my where I can see what I'm doing with my projects. And it's another one that you can use, which, as I say, is just another link to the Evernote note. So there you go. That's some of the things that I covered in my webinar with you. And I really wanted to share these because these can save you so much time and avoid that distraction of going into your project list looking for stuff to do. As long as you're doing that daily planning and you have a workflow set up in your favorite section here in Todoist, then you've got a way that you can stay really focused on the work that you know needs to happen. So I hope you found this episode useful. Thank you so much for watching it. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now, I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, It doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.